author and blogger Rachel Stafford knows about commitment overload. For 2 years, she tried to juggle family responsibilities and a host of volunteer activities. Then one day, she realized she was missing out on her family's life. In her book, Hands Free Mama, Rachel will show you how to minimize daily distractions so you can focus on what really matters.
Please welcome to the 700 Club, Rachel Stafford. Rachel, it's great to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
You know, these crazy phones that are supposed to be so helpful, they send in calls, they alert us to things online, sales that are happening.
Yes.
They're dinging us to remind us of appointments that we have, and you yourself were trapped in that at one point.
I definitely was.
What made you realize that this was an issue?
Well, I had a breakdown breakthrough moment that I like to call it. I was out for a run one morning and I answered the question that I get all the time, which was, how do you do it all? And I realized I was doing it all because I was missing out on life and what really matters in life. You know, the playing, the laughing, the memory making. And the reason I was missing out on life was the phone, the to-do list, and all the pressures that I was putting on myself.
Yeah, some of it your own expectations.
Absolutely, yeah. Yes. Pressure to succeed and pressure to make everything look perfect.
Yeah, even to be the perfect mom, the perfect wife,
yes,
the perfect homemaker. I mean, all of those things. And I guess we're all under some kind of pressure. Today you call yourself the hands-free mama. What
yes.
happened?
Well, that day, I was, like I said, out for a run and I had that breakdown and I thought, well, how can I change? I don't want to miss my life. And that day I felt God's presence and I felt like he was saying, if you take time to simply be instead
yes.
of do, I will guide you. And so I started that very day. I was in the middle of making a sandwich for my little girl. I had the computer open, the phone dinging, you know, I was thinking about what I needed to do. And I felt like I needed to go to her.
Mm-hmm.
And I held her in my arms. She was watching Lion King and she kissed the palm of my hand. And no one had ever done that to me before. And so I thought, that's my confirmation. And God is trying to say, live hands free.
Yeah.
And take little steps to let go of your distractions and be fully present with mm-hmm. your family.
I think that's a call for all of us, no matter what point of life
yes.
that we're at. You know, we have terms that we use for that, like take time to smell the roses
sure.
and that kind of thing. But we are distracted by the small things in life. What are some steps you could share with people that would, because you went cold turkey. I mean,
well, I started designating times of day where I would put all of my distractions away. So I gave my phone a home. I highly recommend that. I actually put it away where I could not see it. I could not hear it. You know, I turned the dings mm-hmm. off. I also, in the car, I put the phone out of reach so I could actually converse with my family. you know, think about that. And then at home, instead of jumping up from the table to clear the table, like it's got to get cleaned up right away, I just let myself be and just yeah. to communicate. Starting your day out, not by reading your emails, but having a quiet moment of devotion or reflection,
mm-hmm.
it just sets the whole day.
Yeah.
And so just little ways that you can say, I'm not gonna let technology run my life. I'm gonna use it as a tool.
Yeah.
But I'm not gonna miss what really matters in my day.
And that's what technology is supposed to be, a tool to living our lives
yeah.
more efficiently, more meaningfully even,
right.
and that's what you have discovered. Do you think that this is a pretty common problem in our country today? I see people all of the time, just two people out to lunch, and they're both not communicating with each other, they're on their cell phones.
Yes, I think people have really had a hard time drawing a boundary between their tech life and their just
it's
really
a little
human.
Addicting, don't you think?
It's absolutely addicting, yes. I mean, there's centers that are popping up right now for tech addiction because it has become so strong
yeah.
and such a pull. And, you know, I never thought I'd have millions of readers reading my
mm-hmm.
blog, but people write to me and say, I'm yearning to learn how to let go of my distractions. I've been waiting for someone to help me and take some steps.
Yeah.
And so, yes, I think people are yeah. really hungry for that human connection.
Well, and sometimes because of the efficiency that it provides, there are expectations even in the workplace that we will always be available,
yes.
that we will always pick up the phone, that we will never, you know, not know exactly what's going
right.
on every second of the day or night. So how do you deal with that when the expectation isn't just from yourself, but from others?
Right. Well, I think it's a really neat thing when people just say, you know, when I go home on the weekend, I tell my boss, you know, this is my family time. If you don't protect your time, people are going to use it.
Sure.
You have to put those boundaries up and say, I'm not gonna be available this weekend or Friday mm-hmm. night. And it's funny because when someone shares that, someone says, huh, that might be a good idea. Maybe I'd like to try that. Yeah. So I think it's something that we lose awareness. We think, mm-hmm. well, I have to be on my phone 24/7. But in reality, we can take a break.
Yeah.
And in those times that you're rejuvenating yourself, there's mm-hmm. just nothing like it.
Yeah. And even need to take a break.
Yes.
You mentioned quiet time with the Lord earlier, and the lack of that falls into that whole
yes.
craziness that
Absolutely.
We allow to be perpetrated in our lives. Well, your book is Hands Free Mama. I want you all to know about it. It's available wherever books are sold. If you're trying to break this habit in your life, you can get your life back, and Rachel's going to tell you how in her book. So get a hold of it. Thank you. It's nice to
Thank
have you,
you
here.
Thank you so
Good
much.
Message.